know, before I go to the chopping block, do you think you could dig up a slug of whiskey for a very nervous guy?
A slug of whiskey?
Yeah.
In this house?
Well, isn't anything ever changed around this mausoleum?
Yes. Bedspreads and underwear.
Well, that's something.
I was just saying, what a lucky girl this is to have you for a husband.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
What is it? What's the matter?
Nothing. I'm fine.
No, you're not. You're sicker than you think. You need a lot of rest and quiet.
Oh, I'm all right. Just a day or two in bed.
Larry, are you sure you can walk? Maybe we can find a wheelchair.
Oh, no. I'm all right. If I could just lean on you a little.
Mister, have you got a half a dollar that isn't working?
Half a dollar?
Too steep?
You might as well ask him for $50.
Listen, old man, could you let me have $50?
You bet. How'd you like it?
Buddy, could I hold you up for a quarter?
With a gun, maybe.
Great work.
Could you spare a thin dime for a cup of coffee?
Are you the nut that's asking people for $50?
Oh, no, officer. All we're trying to get is 50 cents. My friend and I are terribly hungry.
Down and out, huh?
Not at all, officer. We expect to go to work in the morning, but... Oh, we're so hungry tonight, it's hard waiting.
You two married?
No, but, we're engaged. Don't we look it?
Well, I hate to see a young couple hungry. I'll let you have 50 cents. And if you get working, you can pay me back. I'm here in the park.
Oh, thank you, officer. We could never repay you, no matter how much we gave you.
That's all right. Eat hearty.
Thanks, officer.
Thank her. You got a nice girl there.
Hear that? Come on, darling. The losing lover must be a lovely loser.
Well, you're lovely enough, Mimi.
Sure. That's why you married me. Where are you going on your honeymoon?
We don't know yet.
Good place.
Say, it is at that, isn't it, huh?
Boat someplace, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Big boat?
Oh, I guess so.
You know how we'd have gone on our honeymoon, Alice?
No, how?
Rowboat.
A rowboat? Say, that would have been fun, wouldn't it, huh?
Yeah. Wouldn't it?
But you know, you'd have had to do the rowing.
Yeah. Only we wouldn't even had any oars.
No oars? Oh, gee.
No oars. We'd just sit on the sea.
Uh-huh.
And then a yacht would come along and run into us. And the yacht would sink. And then they'd try to get on our boat and we'd just leave them.
How would we leave them without any oars?
Oh, we had an engine all the time.
No.
Say, I must be
Listen,
a little...
Mimi, don't you think you better blow?
Yeah. Oh, it's you, Mimi. It's all right. It's just me. Wishing you goodbye and good luck.
Thank you, Mimi. That's sweet of you.
Gee, you're pretty. So am I.
If you don't mind, dear, One moment.
Take your time. I can spare the blood.
Did you cut yourself?
I cut myself every morning. I kind of look forward to it.
Why don't you use an electric razor?
Can't get used to them.
Oh, that's silly. Bill Cole's been using one for years.
He hasn't got my beard.
Ah. Bill's beard is just as coarse and
tough. I am not interested in discussing the grain and texture of Bill Cole's hair follicles before I've had my breakfast.
All I said was, why don't you use an electric razor?
Because I prefer the clean sweep of the tempered steel as it glides.
No advertising copy, please. And hurry up. Yeah. You'll be late for breakfast.
Sure.
Irene!
Maybe him dead.
What? Irene!
Coming.
You're alive.
Oh. I was just hibernating.
Say, isn't this a great day to get out of the city? Yeah. Especially in an open car? When you go 80 miles an hour in this job, I bet you don't even feel it.
He's feeling it now, aren't you, Nick?
Boy, oh boy, wait till I tell the family I met Nick Charles and Mrs. Charles. This is Mrs. Charles, ain't it?
That's the way we check in at the motels.
No one will get a word out of me, Nick. It's okay, honey. Follow me, Nick. I'll get you there.
Now what?
Oh. Scads of police cars and motorcycles. Oh, and I see an ambulance, too.
Keep an eye on that. It may come in handy. Money.
We almost got insurance money. What's happening? Looks like a riot.
Maybe somebody hit the Daily Double.
What happened?
You know that jockey Golez? The one who was caught throwing the fourth race yesterday?
Mm-hmm.
He was shot.
Why, they're strict at this track.
Sure, it's a dead giveaway. A dame would never pass a mirror like that without looking to see if her slip was showing.
Dame?
Well, that's what Daddy always says.
I never say dame. I always say doll. Dish. Well, anyway, it was a very shrewd deduction.
He's going over to the Thayers this afternoon to meet their youngster. They might ask him to play, and I want him to be at his best. Go on. Get... Astor, you stay out of this.
Madam, I'm very sorry, but no dog committed.
What a mess. Madam,
you cannot take the dog from there.
I'm not taking him. He's taking me.
Madam.
Oops. Women and children first, boys.
Say, what is the score, anyway?
Oh, so it's you he was after.
Hello, sugar.
He's dragged me into every gin mill on the block.
Yeah, I had him out this morning.
Oh, I thought so.
Oh, this is Tommy, my wife.
How are you, Tommy?
How do you do?
Tommy, I don't usually look like this. I've been Christmas shopping.
Madam, I'm afraid we shall take the dog out.
Oh, it's all right, Joe. It's all right. It's my dog. And, my wife.
Well, you might have mentioned me first on the billing.
The dog's well trained. He'll behave himself.
It might bite somebody.
Oh, he's all right. Look, lie down. Lie down. Stand up.
Pretty girl.
Yes, she's a very nice type.
You got types?
Only you, darling. Lanky brunettes with wicked jaws. Leo. Compliments to see you.
Who is she?
Oh, darling, I was hoping I wouldn't have to answer that.
Come on.
Well, Dorothy is really my daughter. You see, it was spring in Venice. And I was so young, I didn't know what I was doing. We're all like that on my father's side.
By the way, how is your father's side?
Oh, it's much better, thanks. And yours?
Say, how many drinks have you had?
This will make 6 martinis.
All right. Will you bring me 5 more martinis? Leo, line them right up here.
Yes, ma'am.
What hit me?
The last martini. How about a little pick-me-up?
No!
I can't lie here. I've got to get up and trim that darn Christmas tree.
What was the idea of pushing me?